Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with the lead editorial. Now the name of the lead editorial is the architecture of censorship. Now this editorial relates to general studies mains examination paper 2, and this also has a relevancy to general studies mains examination paper 4. Now what is this editorial about? First of all, we need to know about that. Now this editorial relates to article 19, and in article 19 it relates to article 19 subsection 1. Now what is this article 19 subsection 1? Now this subsection 1, it relates to a very important right that has been conferred by the constitution to all the citizens of the nation. Now what is this right? This is the right about right to freedom of speech and expression. It is about the right that has been conferred onto the citizens to express themselves, right to freedom of speech and expression. Now before we understand what is this editorial about, we need to understand the importance of this editorial, this article. Now this article is very, very important, because this article allows the citizen to critically analyze the governmental policies. This article allows the citizen to express himself, to let him become part of the political discourse, political debate and political discussion. Had there been not this article 13.19.1, India would not have progressed to the stage where it has rightly reached, or it would not have progressed to the level to which it has already progressed. So the progress of any society, the development of any society, the growth of any society requires that we should be defeating the false, and we should be defeating something that is untrue, something that is black, something that is not worthy. Now all these forces can be defeated provided we are indulging in the discourse and the debate. We can indulge in discourse and debate only and only if we will be expressing our right to freedom of speech and expression. Now, without this right to freedom of speech and expression, we will not be able to counter the wrong. So it is very important that if we want the new paradigms in the society to develop, if we want the civilizational progress to move forward or to move ahead, we require this very right. So this is the importance of this right. Now how this right is related to today's editorial? Now today's editorial, the architecture of censorship, it has been written by Gautam Bhatia. Now Gautam Bhatia is a lawyer, and he critically analyzes any action of the government from the perspective of the legal angle. Now recently it is the Madhya Pradesh government which has banned an old book, An Adivasi Cannot Dance. Now this is the name of the book. Now Madhya Pradesh government has banned this book. Now they have banned this book because this book was highlighting some of the practices of the Santhal community living in Madhya Pradesh. And in order to assuage the wrongdoings of the Santhal community, in order to placate the disenchantment of the Santhal community, Madhya Pradesh government has put a ban on this book. And Gautam Bhatia has analyzed this aspect in depth. According to him, it is this section 95 of CRPC which is to be blamed, because this gives a lot of power to the governments to ban any text which the government believes will lead to communal disharmony. which will lead to a creation of a situation which might lead to a law and order situation. So it is this very art section 95 of the CERPC which is actually hitting at this right that is conferred by the Constitution. And this is something that goes against the spirit of democracy. So Gautam Bhatia wants that the government, onto which such blanket power has been conferred, such a power should not be misused. If they will be misusing this power on now and then basis, it can really curtail or dissuade the progress that the India is bound to make. Because you can only stop, you can only dissuade this right to freedom of speech and expression. You cannot kill it. And there is no logic in killing this right to freedom of speech and expression. Because something good really comes out of this right. That is, the civilizational progress will come out of this. So first of all, this section has been discussed with respect to an Adivasi Cannot Dance book. Now the second thing that has been discussed by the Gautam Bhatia is about another book. And the name of the book is From Godman to Tycoon. This is related to Baba Ramdev. And on the book on Baba Ramdev, that is Godman to Tycoon, an injunction has been imposed by the judiciary. Judiciary ne isko rok diya hai kitab ki release ko. Without going into the nitty-gritties of what the book wants to say or what the book is all about. So Gautam Bhatia is really concerned about how our institutions like that of government, the executive, and the institution like judiciary, they are not internalizing the importance of such articles like 19 and how easily they fall prey to not allow the citizens to express this very right that is the foundation of the democracy in India. Had there been not this right, India would not have trusted with the independence. India would not have trusted with the democracy. India would not have been an independent nation. And India would not be able to progress if we will be continuously applying such laws and such provisions. And if the institutions like the executive, the legislature, and the judiciary will not be in consonance with the requirements of the democracy. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of this channel is BrainyIAS. You can also place orders for the video class packages on BrainyIAS.com. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.